Okay, what's up guys? Welcome to another video of Triple Trouble. In this video we're going to talk about the infamous target panic. First we're going to talk about it a little bit and then we're going to show you a few exercises you can do to help this problem. So what is target panic actually? I think it's basically an irrational fear to either missing the target or hitting the target. And yes, that second option is actually a thing. This shows in many different ways. So there's, for example, not being able to anchor fully, and that's one of the things you can see in my shooting, unfortunately. But there's also, for example, not being able to pull relaxed through the clicker. That can be difficult for some people, not be able to release relaxed. So there's this kind of motion. But it basically all comes down to, it's a fear that's irrational. So what does that mean? When you think about it, it's actually bullshit. Because there's nothing, this is the whole game, right? You miss or hit the target. Well, it's archery, welcome to archery. But still it's there and it's very real. I've been struggling with this for years, so I pretty much know what it feels like, what it looks like. I would dare to say that about 90% of archers know what target panic is because they've experienced it for themselves in one or another form. So it's a real thing, so hopefully I'll be able to help you guys out a little bit. Okay, so there are three steps to beating target panic.
What? Only three?
Yes, guys, only three. But it will take you a long time, so don't think you'll fix this in 5 minutes. Okay, so the first step is recognizing that you have target panic. This could be the most important step. Just admit to yourself, okay, I've got a little slight problem that might be target panic. There's no shame in it. Even the top level archers sometimes have target panic, so who cares, right? First step, admitting that you have it. Second step, decide for yourself that from this moment on you're gonna work on it and you're gonna try and make it better. Then the third step, the last step, is obviously exercising and doing stuff that will help you beat target panic. This can be different for pretty much everyone. Some people might benefit using a clicker, some people might benefit from meditating. There could be a lot of things that help you beat target panic. So we're going to show you a few things that you can do and hopefully they'll be useful to you. Okay, so the first exercise, you're going to stand in a very close distance to the target. Don't go blank bail because then you train yourself to actually do a good shot without a target. So, and once you put on the target, it might fold and you still have target panic. So it's all about relaxing and getting used to aiming in the yellow. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna decide not to shoot the shot. I'm just gonna anchor, look at the yellow, and aim as far as I'm aiming. But and then just come back and do it again. Okay, so it's very easy. I hope you can all do this at home. Few seconds and then just return to starting position. So it's very, very important to decide for yourself, I'm gonna fully extend, fully anchor, look at the target, and just if you don't decide that, it's probably going wrong. So each arrow, you might also want to do this exercise with just one arrow. Throw the rest away, just one arrow, so you don't have that feeling like, oh, there's another one, there's another one. No, there's no other one. You're gonna use this one arrow to get used to aiming in the yellow. Okay, step one. Okay, so it's very tempting to go through this exercise in a few minutes, skip it, and then, oh, I can do this, this is too easy, okay. No, really do this exercise the best you can. And make sure you can aim at the yellow and hold it for seconds long and don't have that reflex of, no. Make sure you can breathe, you feel relaxed, you can feel your muscles, and then it's time to go to step two, which is actually shooting your shot. And if that's too much for you, which is no shame at all, then just go back to step one. Maybe you want to do intermediate steps. Figure that out for yourself. It's not that difficult, but it is difficult to hold yourself to that very important pattern of building it up slowly. So next step is shooting really slowly, holding it for a few seconds, then shooting. Okay, so. En die mag er wel in blijven. Okay, step three is building confidence and building distance. So now we're gonna step back a few meters. Don't go back immediately like 10 or 20 yards or meters. That might be too much. So we'll just step back a few meters now. Don't make it too difficult on yourself. What I personally like to do is start off with step one at this new distance. So just aiming in the middle and not shooting. What might happen in your head is you trigger a kind of response that says, oh, bigger distance, you're not gonna make this. This is more difficult. And yes, it is more difficult, obviously. You're not gonna shoot the same groups at 5 meters, of course. But to counter that, I like to start off with step one again and just don't shoot the shot. Just get used to the distance. Okay, and then step two.
Fientje!
Lekker. Okay, so that story was basically for traditional bows, where you don't have a clicker. I would suggest actually using a clicker. There are clickers for traditional bows as well, so get yourself one of those. It might really help, because for me I was struggling with target panic for years. First I didn't know I suffer from it, and then I just couldn't help it. So I encountered two guys, Gijs and Chef, and they gave me a recurve with a clicker, and I was like okay. So I tried that, and lo and behold, my target panic was gone like that with the recurve and the clicker. Very weird for me, very weird experience, but it was awesome. I felt so relaxed, I could finally shoot a relaxed shot again. And so yeah, I would actually suggest, if you haven't done this, haven't tried this, get yourself a clicker. And this might really help you get used to the to get to full draw and extending and shoot a relaxed shot. So the clicker is a great tool, but it's not a magic pill, unfortunately. You might notice as soon as you don't use the clicker, you go back to the target panic. I had that, I still have that, unfortunately, but it's not a magic pill, but it can help you to shoot a relaxed and nice and slow and controlled shot. So it really has helped me to get used to that full draw and then extending. What you can do with a clicker, if you have target panic with a clicker, so you shoot with a clicker and you still have target panic, what you can do to train is, again, close distance, big target, pull towards the clicker, pull through the clicker, then wait a few seconds and only then release. So you get used to the feeling of not having to shoot when the clicker goes. We actually have a video about that process, about the clicker. You can find it right here. So go there and watch the video. And now I'm gonna demonstrate what I meant. Right, so you draw your normal draw up to the clicker. You let it go, wait a few seconds, and then shoot. Okay?
So for compound, all of the previous steps are the same, except for the letting down of the bow, because it can be a big toll for your shoulder. I am standing at approximately 3 meters from the target. This is so that I can get used to aiming in the gold without freaking out over it. So I'm using a thumb trigger style release, which I'm not super comfortable with. The only way to properly do this for me would be to start up close and just like take baby steps. So go increase the distance slightly over time. So it's really just a matter of holding it in the gold
and just getting used to holding it there. And then slowly pressing the trigger.
So not like that. So that was a good example of me not being concentrated on the shooting, but concentrated on the talking and on making this video, and therefore just smashing the trigger. I'm not afraid to say that I have target panic with a compound. It's something I'm working on, and that's also one of the key points to target panic. Don't be afraid to admit that you have target panic, and the only thing you can do is work on it. So the best way to do this is to start at close distance.
Okay, to summarize this long ass story, there are basically three steps you want to do. First, admit that you have target panic, fully admit it. Second, make the decision that you're going to beat it, that you're going to work at it and that you're going to beat it. So that's the second. Third is do the exercises and do actually go through the motions you need to go through to beat this thing. Okay, so those three steps. If you don't do those, you shouldn't have watched this whole video, okay? If you have done that, the next three steps we just showed are close distance, just aim at the middle or the gold, and get used to aiming at the middle and get a feeling for a relaxed aiming motion, okay? Then second is actually shooting the shot in a relaxed manner, just like we showed you, just like we talked about. And then once you've mastered that at like 5 meters, go back a few meters. That's step three, is going back a few meters every time. And make sure you keep step one and two in your head. Every time it doesn't go the way you want it to go, go back to step two, go back to step one. Okay, fully give yourself to this process. It will take you a long time, probably, I hope not, but so very important to note, and we can't say this enough, it's a mental thing. It's not a physical thing. The body just reacts to your brain, and it's just, it's a mental thing. So all the exercises we showed are actually a mental exercise. It's not the physical, because you know you can do this motion. Of course you can. It's, you know you can do that. So the physical thing is not a problem. It's mental. So keep that in mind. And also, what I actually like to do is some kind of meditation also when shooting. So focusing on your breath, focusing on the feeling in your muscles, that kind of stuff really helped me a lot. So you can do that if you're not into that wishy-washy stuff. I get that, that's fine. However, if you've done all the other stuff and it doesn't work, you might want to go into the wishy-washy stuff. So, okay, little tip. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time, and I hope you enjoyed. Cheers. So with target panic, it's really important to confront your fear, to actually... Run.
Run.